Hello, and welcome to the Australian Building Codes Board 2022 seminar for NCC Volume 3. My name is Tom Roberts, and I'm the Director of Plumbing at the Australian Building Codes Board. Today I'll present on the changes to the allowable lead levels in plumbing products. The ABCB will be reducing the allowable lead content in plumbing products. Products which contain copper alloys and are intended for use in contact with drinking water will be required to have a weighted average of lead content of not more than 0.25%. NCC 2022 will specify the new requirements and will outline the transition period for this change. There are a few reasons for this change. One consideration was for international practices. Australia is a small market on the global scale, and consideration was given to what is happening internationally to ensure that Australia does not create more stringent requirements than other countries. If this happened, this requirement would become a barrier to trade in the importation of plumbing products. As such, this change will align with the level set by other countries, such as the US and Canada. And consistency also ensures that there is suitable technology available to continue to manufacture copper alloy products compliant with this requirement. The second and major consideration was for the health benefits that can be achieved through this change. It is important to remember that existing plumbing products must meet stringent manufacturing and testing requirements to demonstrate compliance to the Australian Drinking Water Guidelines. That said, there are health benefits that can be derived from the use of lead-free plumbing products through further reducing the potential exposure to lead. Most people know that lead isn't great for you. Lead has long been recognised as a cumulative toxin, and once it enters the body, there's no lead level that is considered safe. The negative health impacts of lead are most profound in children under 4 years of age and pregnant women. The advice from various health agencies encourage governments to eliminate non-essential uses of lead where possible, so that is what we've been doing. The ABCB undertook a large amount of research and analysis looking into lead in plumbing products. The Macquarie University was engaged to undertake a literature review to determine the extent that plumbing products and materials may contribute to lead levels in drinking water in excess of those permitted by the Australian Drinking Water Guidelines. The project looked into historical and modern research and the review of international and national literature. Analysis also played a key part in defining the appropriate application of the lead-free requirements of the NCC. A regulation impact statement was developed to consider whether reducing lead content in plumbing products in contact with drinking water can have a measurable impact on reducing lead content in drinking water and the blood lead levels, particularly in the vulnerable populations. Both of these documents are available on the ABCB website. There will be a 3-year transition period to allow manufacturers and suppliers time to ensure that there's sufficient lead-free plumbing products in the market before the 1st of September 2025. For now, there's nothing that plumbers need to do, but beyond the 1st of September in 2025, only lead-free plumbing products will be authorised for installation and existing products will no longer be able to be used. Lead-free is defined in NCC 2022 and outlines that products which are deemed compliant to the lead requirements of the NCC are considered lead-free. This definition ensures consistency in the terminology used within industry. The watermark schedule of products can be found on the ABCB website. This schedule indicates exactly which products need to meet the lead-free requirements. Some examples of products are included copper alloy fittings, valves, taps, mixers, water dispensers such as boiling and cooling units, and water meters, where these products are installed in contact with drinking water. From the 1st of September 2025, products which are required to be lead-free must be certified as lead-free through the Watermark Certification Scheme to be authorised for installation in a plumbing system. Plumbing products that do not conform to the lead-free requirements will no longer have a valid Watermark certification and will not be authorised for installation in a plumbing system. Now that we have covered why we are moving to lead-free, let's talk about how we are moving to lead-free. The transition to lead-free plumbing products has already commenced. It is important to note that lead-free requirements for products that are not retrospective. That is, they only apply to products installed in new plumbing work. The Lead in Plumbing Products Implementation Plan on the ABC, is on the ABCB website. This is a roadmap for the transition process and provides information about the transition process and sets out key milestones and review points for installation and enforcement. To enable industry to commence the manufacturing and testing and certification of plumbing products conforming to the lead-free requirements, the ABCB has published a watermark notices of direction. The first notice provides direction on the certification transition arrangements for lead-free requirements for plumbing products as outlined in NCC 2022. The second notice provides direction on the materials to be used in the manufacture of lead-free plumbing products. This notice outlines the process to achieve compliance with the lead-free requirements of NCC 2022. It outlines the certification transition arrangements for watermark conformity assessment bodies and license holders that they must comply with, and the materials to be used in the manufacture of lead-free plumbing products. Specific certification procedures are being developed to ensure consistent, harmonised certification activity. Registration of a mandatory certification trademark is being pursued with IP Australia. The images you can give you an indication of what it might look like. Products certified to the lead-free requirements must be marked with the lead-free watermark and not the watermark. Lead-free marking requirements will indicate compliance with lead-free requirements, easily differentiate existing certified products and lead-free certified products, and assist regulation at the point of installation. Packaging, marketing, or promotional material for products certified to the lead-free requirements may also choose to use the lead-free watermark. Lead-free compliance must be indicated on the watermark certificate of conformity, the product listing on the watermark database, and the scope of use statement provided with the product. Products marked with the lead-free watermark may retain any international lead-free product marking that is already on the product. As we move closer to the 1st of September 2025 and the conclusion of the transition period, the ABCB will release additional education and awareness and resources to help support industry in the change to lead-free plumbing products. The ABCB has some frequently asked questions and the implementation plan, which will continue to be updated as the go-to guide. Other awareness initiatives will be released throughout the transition period. To summarise some of the key points about the move to lead-free, existing certified products that are not recertified as lead-free are safe to use and will remain authorised for installation until the 31st of August 2025. The transition period concludes on the 1st of September 2025. After this date, lead-free products will only be authorised for installation. Inherently lead-free products, such as those made of stainless steel that are not required to be certified to lead-free, may voluntarily be certified or recertified as lead-free. If you have any questions, please review the ABCB resources available on the ABCB website or get in touch with us through our Contact Us page. Thank you for watching.